I'm going to show you how to make this map in ArcGISPro that looks like it was made in the 90s.
The 1890s.
And it's going to be super easy and snappy because it's comprised of layers entirely from Living Alice. I'll start with the world imagery layer, and on top of that, I'll add the hillshade layer, and I'll give that hillshade layer a luminosity blend mode. Next, I'll add roads and boundaries, and I'll do this using the human geography details layer made by my friend Andy Skinner. And I'll give this layer a blend mode of linear burn, and I'll make it 70% transparent. But those gray oceans just aren't gonna cut it, so I'm gonna add bathymetry light for some nice blue tinted depths. Speaking of depths, I'd like to add a vintage style terrain layer to this, so I'll search for generalized terrain. And I'll bake this into my map using trusty old linear burn and a transparency of 80%. Now I'd really like to know what I'm even looking at, so I'm gonna add a labels layer called Old Timey from Living Atlas. I'll give it that linear burn blend mode and a transparency of 50% so they recede a little bit. So far we've been adding data to our map. Data that in 1890 would be an unimaginable national treasure. But I'd like to breathe some tactile life into this map. Make it look like something I can touch and smell. So I've added the folded paper texture and parchment texture. I'll give the folded paper texture a blend mode of color burn, and the parchment texture will get a blend mode of linear burn. I'd like to increase the effect of that parchment texture, so I'll duplicate it by holding the control key and dragging down. And because this whole base map is made up of Living Atlas tile layers, it covers the whole world at all scales. Now, whew, these 9 layers look like a lot. They don't look like a lot if I group it and collapse the group. And that's it. That's how you make this base map in ArcGIS Pro. But if you're feeling sneaky, you could just download the project package. I'll link to it below.